Hello and good afternoon, everybody. Respected staff, principal, dignitaries, ladies, gentlemen, and the most adorned listeners, the students. Fitness is not a compound, it's a phenomenon. It's a lifestyle that you acquire for yourself. The psychological contentment of well-being, what you achieve out of fitness, is its value encashed. Can we have the presentation, please? So friends, fitness for me is not just doing exercise. Fitness gives me a holistic feeling of well-being, happiness. It boosts my confidence as a health worker, and it also improves my efficiency as a doctor. Because every now and then, as a gynecologist, I see patients who require a change in their lifestyle, who require a change in their food habits so that they become more fit, more healthy, and that helps me in curing and controlling their disease. Now, I always feel that if I am not fit, what am I going to preach? So what I do, because of my haphazard schedule, now I don't know when I come back to home because it's an emergency branch. I am continuously on call. Being in private sector, I'm running my own hospital, 24 hours on call. So I really need to have a gym at my home rather than hitting the gym somewhere else because I cannot tell them what time I'm going to come. So I work on my body because my work schedule is entirely sedentary. I keep sitting in the OPD. I see patients. When I go to the theater, I'm standing in one position and operating. So I really need to work my body. Otherwise, body jam ho jayegi. So what I do is I follow the motto, if I take care of my body today, the body will take care of me tomorrow. Now, if I just tell you my history, my road towards fitness, it was like a roller coaster ride. It took me a long, long time to understand what is fitness. Because fitness for me, for the initial couple of years, was just staying slim. Just like my previous speaker said, having the nice curves and slim and look good in the dresses. That is exactly what fitness for me was. Now, born in an educated middle class family, I was a chubby, chubby child. We are three sisters, I'm the eldest. We were all chubby, mom, dad, all the three sisters, because it was in our genes. We were never slim. I never cared, because when I was a child till about 12 years of age, I was a good student, happily eating, working in the school, playing outdoor games, because we didn't have the computer gadgets that you people have. So I was happy, never cared about the comments which kept floating, tu to moti ho rahi hai, are kuch kar yaar, kitni moti ho rahi hai. I never cared. Now, then I just came at the junction of childhood and teenage, that is age 12 and 13, when I suddenly became very conscious of myself, my health, my looks, and how the people are looking at me, my surroundings. That is when these floating unwanted comments, we Indians have a habit of giving comments unnecessarily. We don't want them, but we still give them. So, they would tell my mom, Neelam, your daughter, the eldest one, do something about her. Kitni badi lagti hai. She's so fat. She's not fat, she's plump. Kahan se 12 saal ki lagti hai? She looks 18. So you need to do something about it. So being a Pisces, it really hit me here like a bomb. What did I do? I stopped eating. I completely stopped eating. That is something I really want to share with you people. I was 12. I knew that every food has a caloric value. I would just turn the packet, read the calories, the amount of calories that's in there, and I would try and cut down the food that my mom gave me. I tried to hide from her. I would go in my room, try to feed my little sister who was 6 years younger to me. If she wouldn't eat, I'll throw it in the bin. The whole day, I would stand in front of the mirror measuring my waist. The whole day, I would be like standing on the weighing scale and measuring my weight. And I always had this illusion, or rather hallucination, you can say, that I'm getting fat, although I was going the other way around. So actually, I tried to hide it from my parents, but I couldn't because I was shrinking. I was actually shrinking into a skeleton. And my parents noticed, they really got worried. They talked to me. I started crying. I said, please don't feed me because I really want to look slim. I want to look good. You are all fat. I want to stay slim. I didn't realize I was actually suffering from a psychological disorder. It's an eating disorder called anorexia. Nobody at that stage knew. I'm talking about 1987. At that time, I was a kid. I didn't know. My parents were non-medicos. Now that I am a doctor, when I started studying my medical in the medical college, I came across this disease. And I came to know that it was actually a psychological, neurological disease which I was suffering from. Where a person thinks that she's going fat, but actually it's the other way around. So my parents, they couldn't convince me. They talked to the friends. They couldn't convince me either. Then this gentleman, Dr. Anand, I still remember his name, a good friend of my father, he knew how to handle me. He showed me my pictures. Sonal, look at yourself. Is that how a 13-year-old girl should look? You look like a chimpanzee. Look at yourself. You've got all skin and bones. When you laugh, your eyes go inside the hollow. We can't see your eyes. and your teeth jut out because you got big teeth. So you look like a chimpanzee. Is that how a 30-year-old girl should look? I wish I could show you more photographs, but I was so embarrassed to see those photos. I just tore them off. And we didn't have internet at that. I mean, the digital photographs were not there. So I tore them off. The only photograph I had was this one. My mom, myself standing, and the two little sisters there. So that, because of his efforts, Dr. Anand's efforts, and my parents' caring attitude, I came out of that psychological disorder, started eating. Back in 1987, now 2018, 30 years down the lane, I have never ever crossed that bracket of normalcy. I became so conscious ever since. I have always maintained my weight within the normal bracket. Then came the school, right? In the school, I was a meritorious student, kept winning scholarships and medals. Very hectic. I was good in sports as well. In school, you don't get time to do exercise because the school itself makes you so busy. And with the outdoor activities, I never put on weight. Plus, I was very, very conscious. So what did I lose out of this anorexia nervosa? I lost my height. My mother crips many a times. The way you were growing, you could have been 2-3 inches longer than what you are right now, taller than what you are right now. That is what I lost. Then my aspiration to become a doctor landed me in a medical college where I don't know how the 9 years elapsed. It was so hectic. Clinics, classes, competition, cutthroat competition, exams, then awkward eating hours, awkward sleeping hours, night duties. Then there were those phases of depression and anxiety, which I think every student goes through, especially in the medical college, where this hormone called serotonin gets secreted in your brain and you become bulimic. Whenever you are anxious and nervous, you see, you tend to eat a lot. That is the hormone serotonin working for you. So even I used to gain 2-3 kgs during exams. But being a conscious person, I would just cut it down as soon as the exams were over. I would stick to a healthy diet, stop my mess food, get some fruits, get some exercise. If I can join some yoga classes for 7-10 days, do some exercise on the terrace. My friends would call me crazy because they were sitting and chatting in the mess. I was doing exercise. But this is how I was. I would seclude myself from the friendship, from the circle, because I know I can join them later. But I would do exercise because I didn't want to get a belly. Right? Then I was a very passionate dancer. There was not a single cultural program in which I would not indulge myself. I'm still a very passionate dancer. It is all for all the ladies who are listening, for all the people who want to be fit but do not have time to go to the gym. You really don't need to spend time and money on the gym. You just need to see, check what you're eating and how much calories you're burning. Whatever eating you have to burn. So dancing is a very good exercise. It is very energetic. It is very, entertaining as well. Exercise is boring. Some people like aerobics because it is with music. Otherwise, exercise can be very boring. Now, coming to the scientific advantages of exercise. First of all, it increases your cardiovascular endurance, cardiorespiratory endurance. That is your capacity, the capacity of your heart to pump oxygen to the muscles that are working for you. Increases your strength, your power, the endurance. What is endurance? Endurance means you're doing repeated actions. Your muscle is doing repeated actions without using maximum force again and again and again. Now, practically, this has helped me because I'm an endoscopic surgeon. I do keyhole surgeries. For 4 hours, 5 hours, I have to stand like this. The patient is here, we make 2 holes and scissor and forceps. We do not look inside the patient, we look at the monitor. Because what we are doing is like a video game. Whatever we are doing inside, we see there. So initially, say 6-7 years back, when I started laparoscopy, very difficult for me to stand like this for hours together. Within half an hour, 1 hour, I would get shoulder sprain or my neck would become stiff. I had to go out of the OT, get a massage, come back again. But now, I've crossed all these things because now I'm fit enough to stand for 4 to 5 hours, do the surgery, and I'm yet very enthusiastic to do another surgery after that. What else does it do? It increases your flexibility. Now, God has given us a flexible body. We have good range of movement on all the joints, but you do not need to be perfect because nobody is perfect. I keep myself flexible because that is my choice. Your joints should be flexible enough, fair enough, so that they do not trouble you when you're getting old. They should be supple and healthy. Balance. Now, balance is not just physical balance, it is your mental balance as well. We will come to that later. Fitness is not just physical, it's a combo pack of physical as well as mental. When your brain tunes with your body, it tells you to stay in one position. Now, I am not that fit right now that I can close my eyes and focus with the brain. You can see my eyes are open. If I close my eyes, I'll fall down. So people who are more fit than me, they can actually close their eyes and then their brain tells them to stay in that position, the tree pose that I'm doing. So practice makes a man perfect. Power, speed, everything comes with practice. I tell you, the people who are starters, just like my previous speaker said, her aunt, she joined the gym and she left it within 4 days. So that is because you get a lot of pain initially. especially the weaker parts of your body which you do not move. If you keep sitting, your knees, your shoulders, they don't move. I keep writing with my pen, my wrist is flexible, but my knees, my shoulders won't move. So I get a lot of pain. I got a lot of pain initially when I started gymming. So this is normal. Your weaker parts of your muscles, of your body will cry out of fatigue. Do not stop exercising because of that pain. Take some painkillers, go to the doctor, keep exercising. They will slowly, slowly calm down. Now we all say healthy mind in a healthy body. Why? Because mentally, what does mental fitness mean? Mental fitness means you're training your brain to tune with your body and you're increasing the strength of your mind to deal with the outer world. What happens when you exercise? It releases endorphins. These are the happy hormones which get released and they decrease the pain stimulus to your brain. So many chronic pains which like backache, headaches which you come and to the doctor with, the doctors cannot cure it. I cannot cure it. I tell them to go and do yoga, exercise. Because that is a meditation. It decreases the pain stimulus. Moreover, it increases the blood flow to the brain, so your sleep pattern improves, your emotional stability becomes better. Of course, you will be the same person, your personality won't change, but your anxiety, anger, stress, depression, everything is a combo pack of life. That will definitely decrease because then you become a positive person. Moreover, it also helps in fighting many chronic diseases like hypertension because it reduces stress, diabetes, PCOD, again a hormonal disorder. Exercise increases insulin sensitivity. That is why we doctors have to advise the diabetic patients or the PCOD patients to go and regularly to the gym or go jogging, exercise, because it really helps. Thirdly, the most important part, it gives you a very glowing skin. Why? Because exercise increases the blood flow of the skin and also releases certain antioxidants which decrease cell damage and makes your skin glow and your hair glow. This is what we want, isn't it? Now, what is the role of food? It is said these days, if you go to a gym instructor, 70 to 80% of your fitness with this will depend upon the food you eat, not upon the exercise. So, first of all, we Indians are blessed because we have a wonderful diet. Our diet is famous worldwide. We have full fiber, carbohydrates, fat, proteins, vitamins, minerals, you just name it. We just need to know how much we need to eat in one portion and how many portions we need to eat. That will vary from person to person. Your age, your digestive system, your workouts, your job profile, everything, and your family culture. Yes. So eat for the body you want, not for the body you have. If I broadly speak about carbohydrates, fats and proteins, fats are rich sources of energy. You do not need a lot of fat in your body because then you cannot burn it out. Proteins are the building blocks of body. So growing children and adults like me who are working out every day, hard workout, we need proteins to repair the muscles which are actually undergoing fatigue. Carbohydrates are needed by the brain. Please do not stop carbohydrates when you do dieting because if you stop them, your brain will not work. Carbohydrates are instant sources of energy. When you feel fatigued, when you feel vertigo, you're having a vertigo, lethargic, just take some sugar, you'll feel better. Instant sources of energy. If you take too much of carbohydrate, then it will get stored in the body as fat, which we do not want. If you take less of carbohydrates, then how will the body get energy from? It will start breaking down your proteins, which you don't want. So stick to a good diet. You can check on the internet. Everything is available now. But depends upon your body structure, definitely. Now, do not do crash dieting. Now, that is me in 2001. In my first pregnancy, I went 22, 25 kgs bloated up like a balloon. I have a tendency of weight gain, especially in pregnancy. As a gynecologist, I know. Water retention is a problem with many ladies. I get a lot of water retention and I'm blessed by God. I do not suffer from indigestion, nausea, vomiting. So I eat. So I really put on a lot of weight. This was 2001, just before going for cesarean. And that is just post 10 days post cesarean. So not much of a change. Now living in Jodhpur 2001, living with in-laws in a joint family, how do I reduce weight? They made me eat all the 10 kg of ghee. That was very important. Now, my first pregnancy, I couldn't say no. Even though I'm a doctor, my husband is a doctor, we couldn't say no. You do not want to hurt the sentiments of your mother-in-law, who is like preparing for your first baby, and meri bahu aayi hai, nahi bahu hai, usko khilana hai. So I ate everything, 10 kgs of ghee, my God. Two months, they fed me like this, but I did not gain a single kg. But my weight remained static. 22 kgs, jo tha, waise ka waise hi raha. Now I really got conscious, ab kya karu? Kaise niklu ghar se? Because I was so conscious about my weight from the very beginning, तो मैंने क्रैश डाइटिंग शुरू करी, क्रैश डाइटिंग टोटली पूरा खाना बंद कर दिया, बिकॉज मदर इन लॉ का अटेंशन डाइवर्ट हो गया. दो महीने उन्होंने भर भर के खिला दिया, उसके उनको लगा भी खा लेगी खुद ही. तब मैंने छुप छुप के क्रैश डाइटिंग शुरू करी. आई स्टॉप्ड एवरीथिंग. जब भूख लगती थी पानी पी लेती थी, दूध पी लेती थी, थोड़ा बहुत पनीर खा लेती थी. सो मैंने तीन महीने के अंदर इंस्टेड ऑफ रिड्यूसिंग 20 kgs आई केम डाउन टू 25 kgs. And that was bad because then at the age of 29, I started looking old. Dark circles around the eyes, my skin lost the luster, my hair became dry. Instead of getting good compliments, I got comments from people, you were looking better when you were fat. So you don't want that. So this was a mistake I committed, which I would never do again. So I was more prepared in my second pregnancy. Luckily, second pregnancy happened in 2006 when I was working in Scotland. Now working in UK, So working in UK, it was easy to follow a proper fitness schedule. I knew I'm going to bloat up. I bloated up again, 25 kgs. Now, this time my husband was there in working in England. I was working in Scotland. We had two kids to manage, au pair to manage, too much work. But then going to gym there, it comes in a normal lifestyle. It was not like living in Jodhpur, like a social taboo. In Jodhpur, I cannot tell my in-laws that I'm going to the gym, you take care of my baby, even for 1 hour. It is like a not a easy cup of tea for everyone. So I had to do crash dieting. Now in UK, I made up my program, my fitness schedule. I stick to proteins. Being a doctor, I knew it all. It was very easy to plan my schedule. I joined the gym. There, the gyms are open till 12 midnight because people come as they want. Well, whatever time they want, they can go. For the children, the newborn children, there are crutches. You can leave your baby, the newborn baby, and they take good care of. So at home, sometimes my husband, sometimes my au pair, or sometimes the crutches, I would leave the baby there, both the children there. My son was 5 and she was just newborn. So it was easy for me. That was my first step towards target-oriented fitness, and I have maintained it. Still, that was 12 years back. Till now, I know exactly what fitness is. So I think this is what we need to know. We need to design our own schedule of fitness. This is what everybody needs to do. According to your family customs, according to your life schedule, your family should not get disturbed, your body structure, your job profile, you need to decide what your body can do, the frequency, that is FITT. F means frequency, how many times in a week you can exercise, intensity, how much intensity of exercise you can do. Same age people cannot do the same kind of exercise, the bodies are different. The type of exercise and the timing of exercise. I devote sometimes half an hour, sometimes even 1 hour, sometimes even more, because I love exercising. It is in my schedule. If I get time, I can do it. Not everybody could do that. So plan your own program. I have developed a relationship with my body, and like every other relationship, if I cheat on my relationship, it is not going to work. So this is what I have achieved. So friends, today I'm standing here, 45 years age. I'm a gynecologist. I'm a managing director of my own hospital. Apart from doing surgeries and routine work, I have a habit of training. You can say I have a knack of training doctors, because I got this training attitude from my father, who was a professor in chemical engineering department. So because I'm a trained laparoscopic surgeon and trained colposcopist, every now and then I train young and enthusiastic doctors. I run courses every 2 to 3 months for them. I train them for colposcopy, for hysteroscopy. Then every now and then I'm organizing national level and state level conferences, because I love getting involved in academics. At home, I'm a homemaker as well. I have to take care of the kids, the house, the domestic work. I've got a 16-year-old son, a 12-year-old daughter. I'm a social worker as well. I'm a philanthropist. I'm a Rotary Club member. Then recently, Lions Club Jodhpur Fort started a new endeavor of manufacturing sanitary napkins, that is biodegradable sanitary napkins. They made me the brand ambassador. So we are working together to promote the use of sanitary napkins in the rural population especially, and promoting menstrual hygiene in India. That in turn leads to reduction of cervical cancer, which is a deadly disease. Again, I was pronounced as one of the brand ambassadors of Beti Bachao Beti Padhao program, which was a project, which is a project started just a few months ago by Rajasthan government. It's a topic very close to my heart, and I feel privileged to be a part of it. Now, what gives me so much energy? It is the fact that I'm fit. My enthusiasm comes because of my fitness, because I love myself more than what love I can give to my family, my husband. Because for me, I come first. If I am fit, if I can take care of myself, I can take care of my family. If I am fit, I can take care of my children, I can take care of my husband, I can take care of the house, everything. So ladies, you need to really think about it, that do not think ki we are the last priority, we are the first priority, we are the engine of the house. Agar engine band ho jayega, to ghar kaun chalayega? So take out some time for yourself. Just wanted to share this picture with you. Recently, I have been crowned as Mrs. India Earth 2017. That was in October. And now that I'm the winner, so they are sending me to Las Vegas to represent India as Mrs. Earth International. So I owe this to my enthusiasm, my fitness, and of course, the loving support of my family. I wish my husband was here. He couldn't make it. So my husband, my friends, my family, they thought that I am the perfect taker of this crown. And so there I am. So this is, friends, my fitness encashed. I will just finish with a Hindi proverb. Toot jata hai shisha patthar ke takrane se. Toot jata hai shisha patthar ke takrane se. Toot jaye patthar, aisa shisha talash karo. Behtar se behtar ki talash karo. Jo mil jaye agar nadi, to samandar ki talash karo. Thank you very much.
Very well said, and thank you so much, Dr. Parihar.